Welcome to the course Depreciation, Alternate Investment and Profitability Analysis. We are continuing with module 2, which is Alternative Investment. In this lecture, I will be covering perpetuity method, which is a method to select alternate investments. Perpetuity or capitalized cost method. Because of the varying service life, it was necessary to arrive at a least common multiple of service lives in the present worth method. Sometimes it may be difficult and time consuming to arrive at a least common multiple of estimated lives of all the assets involved in study. In such cases, it is much easier to compare the alternatives using capitalized cost method. Capitalized worth is the present worth of a perpetuity. It indicates that the amount of money needed at present time such that the interest earned will cover the cash flow requirements forever for the investment. This method is generally used by governments. An assumption is made here that the assets, when renewed, repeat their cost history. Capitalized costs are annual costs divided by the interest rate. For example, if rupees 20,000 at the end of 10 years at 10% interest is required, one has to pay 1254.91 a year, and this value has been calculated from the annuity formula, which converts a future value to an annuity, which has been given in the slide. For the 10 preceding years, for this case, the capitalized cost becomes 1254.91 divided by 0.1, which is the value of I, which comes out to be 12549.1, which means that if 12549.1 is invested today, that is now, will become 32549.1 in 10 years. And if 20,000 from this is spent at the end of the 10 year, then rupees 12459.1 will remain and will again grow to rupees 32549 after 10 years later. Thus, the cycle of payment of rupees 20,000 at the end of 10th year can be made for an infinite period. Now, formula used, what are the formulas we have to use in this are, now F to A, future value to annuity, this is A is equal to F, A by F, I n, and this formula, this one is equal to F into 1 I divided by 1 plus I to the power n minus 1. And present value of a perpetuity is equal to PV is equal to A by I. Now, let us apply this in different numericals. Now, objective 1, given the capital investment at different timeline, attractive rate of return, unequal estimated lifespan of capital investment, annual operating cost, compare two different investments based on capitalized cost method. for example 1, two different alternatives A and B are available to supply water to a remote area of Aligarh, which is comparatively arid from mountains of Himalaya. In alternative A pipeline can be laid down this is 100 crores will be required major overhauling every 10 years costing, this is 1000 crores, 100 crores. Overhauling is 100 crores 10 years, every 10 years. An annual upkeeping cost of the pipeline is 10 crores per year. Now, for the B, to construct a canal from the Ganga River to Haridwar to Aligarh costing 1500 crore, overhauling cost is 60 crore every 12 years. Upkeeping cost is 15 crore per year and the value of I is 10%. Now, 1 crore is this. So, let us analyze this and suggest which alternative I should select based on the perpetual cost method. So, solution: alternative A. Capital cost of pipeline is equal to 1000 into 10 to the power 7 rupees. One time capital cost of 100 crores required overhauling over 10 years. So, perpetuity will be annuity of future value of 100 crores taking n equal to 10 divided by I. So, what I have to do, this 100 crores is a future value, but as after 10 years I have to spend 100 crores. So, I have to find out the annuity of this 100 crores, that means annuity of a future value taking n equal to 10 and then divide it by I. So, this comes out to be 100 into 10 to the power 7 into I divided by I into 1 plus I to the power n minus I. This is the formula. And if I solve this, this becomes 100 into 10 to the power 7 into 0.627453 equal to 62.7453 into 10 to the power 7. So, this perpetuity of this, that means if I spend this much of money, then I will get enough money to spend 100 crores every 10 years. Now, one time capital required for paying 10 crore annually perpetually equal to 10 divided by 0.1, which is the value of I, becomes 100 crores. So, the total capital required for the project to run it perpetually for A, this is 1000 into 10 to the power 7 plus 62.7453 to the power 7 plus 100 to the power 7. This comes out to be 1162.7453 crore. Similarly, for alternative B, we can calculate. Now, the capital cost is equal to 1500 into 10 to the power 7, one time capital required for overhauling every 12 years is equal to 60 into 10 to the power 7 into I divided by I 1 plus I to the power n minus 1. This value, this comes out to be 60 into 10 to the power 7 into 0.467633 equal to 28.057989 10 to the power 7. Now, one time capital required for paying rupees 15 crore annually perpetually. Equal to 15 divided by I equal to 15 divided by 0.1 equal to 150 crore. So, total capital required here in the case of B is 1500 into 10 to the power 7 plus 28.057 into 10 to the power 7 plus 150 into 10 to the power 7 is equal to 1678.057 crore. So, as the alternative A requires less capitalized cost thus than the alternative B, it should be selected. This is example 2. Two plans A and B exist for building construction. For plan A, and total initial investment of 60 lakhs is required, for which 40 lakhs will be spent on permanent construction and the rest 20 lakhs will be spent immediately on temporary structure, which will require renewal every 15 years. The annual operating cost of plan A will be rupees 50,000 every year. However, for plan B, an initial investment of 40 lakhs is required of a permanent nature. In addition to it, an additional investment of rupees 30 lakhs on a permanent structure is required after 10 years from now. The annual operating cost of plan B is rupees 20,000 per year. If attractive rate of return is 10%, land is free of cost and is not be included in computation, then using capitalized cost method, find out whether you will prefer plan A or plan B. This numerical we have solved using other methods also. So, let us solve it. Initial capital investment equal to 40 lakhs. Capitalized cost of the temporary structure of 20 lakh will stay for 15 years. So, initial capital investment that will produce 20 lakhs each 15 years perpetually this can be given by 20 lakh into I divided by I into in bracket 1 plus I this I am converting my initial investment that is P2A. So, this will be 1 minus 1 plus I to the power minus 15 and this comes out to be rupees 2629475.538. Now, please note that 20 lakhs is the present worth value of the investment as it is done at the same time as the investment 40 lakhs. That means,
in the timeline t equal to 0, here I am investing 40 lakhs plus 20 lakh. So, this is the initial value here, 20 lakh, and this initial value 20 lakh, the present value has to be converted into a annuity, and that annuity has to be divided by I to convert into perpetuity. So, this is done like this. Now, capitalized cost upkeeping is equal to 50,000 divided by I equal to 5 lakh. So, the net capitalized cost is 40 lakh plus 2629475.538 plus 5 lakh, which comes out to be rupees 712947.538. So, here we write down net capitalized cost, cost for A is equal to rupees 712947.538. Similarly, for plan B, I can calculate. Initial capital investment equal to 40 lakhs. Capitalized cost of the temporary structure costing rupees 30,000 lakh each 10 years. From now, perpetually is equal to 30 lakhs into I divided by I into 1 plus I to the 10 minus 1. Now, why we will see that this formula is changed in compared to the first one, because at the first one that 20 lakh was the present value, here the 30 lakh is future value. So, we are converting a future value to annuity, and that is why this formula is changed, and this comes out to be rupees 1882361.846. Now, the capitalized cost for upkeeping amount ₹20,000 each year is equal to 20,000 divided by I is equal to 20,000 divided by 0.1 equal to 2 lakh. Now, if we add net capitalized cost for B is equal to 40 lakh plus this value 188,236.846 plus this value 2 lakh, and this comes out to be 60,882,361.846. Now, as the net capitalized cost for plan B is less than plan A, plan B is selected for investment. So, this is selected for investment. To summarize, we have seen that the perpetuity or capitalized cost method can solve some problems easily depending upon the situation of the problem and that of the problem. And here we have seen that how to apply this technique for alternative investment, that is perpetuity or capitalized cost method. Thank you.